Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about what you can do if the C or D drive letter is missing in Windows 10. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description. Okay, let's start off by running the hardware troubleshooter. Now the hardware troubleshooter is not with the rest of the troubleshooters. So to get to this one, you're going to have to open a run box. Type in msdt.exe space hyphen ID space device diagnostic. Click OK, and this will launch the hardware troubleshooter. Click on Next and follow any of the on-screen prompts. Once that's finished, restart your system and see if you can then detect the missing drive letter. How to manually show the drive letters? We're going to go to the Start search and type in folder options to open the File Explorer options. Then we're going to go to the View tab. We're going to be looking for Show Drive Letters. Make sure that the box is checked. Then click Apply and click OK. Then go back to File Explorer to this PC, and the drive letter should be visible. If this didn't work, then we have to ensure that the drive has a drive letter assigned to it in disk management. In the disk management, every drive is assigned a drive letter, but if it's missing in Windows disk management, we can get it back. So, right click on the start menu, go to disk management. Find the one that you're after and right click on it. And we want to look for change drive letter and paths. This will allow you to add the drive letter, to change the drive letter, and even remove the drive letter. If the last option, remove, is selected and applied, then the letter of the target drive will be removed and disappeared in disk management. This can be one of the reasons for the missing drive letter. So to reverse this change, choose add to assign a letter to the selected drive. It is essential to assign the drive with the original letter, because if not, then programs relying on the original letter might not work as desired. If the original letter is taken by a new drive, change the letter of the new drive to another available letter, then allocate the released letter to the target drive. In other words, meaning that if something happened and this backup drive accidentally got deleted or removed or whatever, and the E drive became the D drive, I would have to go in and rename this one the E drive so I could name that one the D drive. We can also use a registry tweak in order to do this. We're going to have to launch the registry editor and go to H key local machine system mounted devices. See if a device is shown as being mounted to a specific drive letter. We have C, D, E, F, and G right here. Then, right-click it, click Rename, and change the letter to any other unused letter. We can also try and update the disk drive's driver, and this may help. So, let's go to Device Management, then disk drives, right click on the particular device in question, and select to update the device driver. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.